The Technion is the first institution of higher education in Israel. The cornerstone was laid in 1912 with Albert Einstein among its early supporters. Classes began in Haifa in 1924 with just 16 students. When the State of Israel was proclaimed, Prime Minister David Ben-Gurion said more engineers were needed to build Israel's infrastructure. That was a call to action for the Technion. To meet the demand for more engineers, the Technion moved its campus to the slopes of Mount Carmel. Until the 1970s, the Technion was the only institution in the country that trained engineers. The whole development of the economy of Israel grew thanks to the Technion, lifting Israel out of the agricultural age to center stage as a world leader in science, medicine, engineering, and technology. Technion scientists were making breakthrough discoveries, expanding untold possibilities, pioneering treatments for life-threatening diseases, becoming leaders in areas of new research, and opening the doors to new technologies, including in security and defense, and in developing huge advances in fields such as optoelectronics, nanotechnology, and energy. Since its founding in 1940, the American Technion Society has played an invaluable role in the Technion's development. From supporting the construction of dormitories and buildings with their laboratories, classrooms, and libraries on its 300-acre campus, to the university's emergence as a leading academic and research center.
My name is Nadav Cohen. I'm a student here in the Technion in the Faculty of Mechanical Engineering.
My name is Mor Sandowski. I'm a graduate student of Biotechnology and Food Engineering.
We are here to get the best education in science and technology.
And that's why we chose the Technion.
The Technion is proud of the high caliber of its students and its faculty of scientists, who are among the most distinguished and respected in the world.
The Technion is one of the leading technological scientific institutes in the world. To maintain our status, we need to recruit to the Technion the best of the best. We are competing against the top universities in the world. Our vision is to bring to the Technion the best minds we can find all over the world, people who will make the new generation of Technion researchers and Technion teachers. Our job is to bring them here, to provide them with the means to continue their scientific career and build laboratories, teaching classes, and educate the new generations of Israeli engineers and scientists and physicians.
Faculty recruitment is a top priority of the Technion and the American Technion Society as well.
The funds that I got from the ATS not only supported my research in terms of equipment, facility, and material, but also provided fellowships for master and PhD students that did all the wonderful work that we had until now. But this support is not only for myself. Actually, money that is given by the ATS is supporting different labs all over the campus. And this is a very huge help for every researcher at the Technion.
Technion is a world-class university and put Israel on the map of technology and science worldwide.
The Technion has been a bastion of Israel's security, information technology, in biotechnology, medical technology, in nanotechnology. In all these areas, the Technion is a world leader.
Throughout Israel, Technion graduates are the force behind technological breakthroughs, propelling the Israeli economy forward.
Everyone knows that almost any startup you look at, any entrepreneur, has been to the Technion, or the key employees in the company graduated the Technion. So the Technion is the premier startup nation university and continues to play a critical role in providing top level engineers for the whole startup economy to flourish.
And if I look around, who are the people that created the high-tech industry? The majority are Technion graduates.
Technion is the engine that runs the progress of Israel in the high technology areas.
There is no family like Technion supporters. They are truly a family. Exceptional people who understand that to support the Technion is to support Israel.
I have never encountered the level of proprietary commitment that people who are involved with the American Technion Society feel about what goes on in the Technion. They feel it very deeply, and they relate to the science that they're funding, the individuals that they're assisting, on a very, very personal and intense level.
Technion is not a simple organization. We are relying heavily on the good heart and open heart of Jews all over the world that have supported us along the years. The American Technion Society and wonderful people who have gone with us a long way.
I am very grateful to the American Technion Society. It was important for all this work. I don't think that this work could have been done without your help.
My advice to people that are willing to both to invest and donate philanthropically in Israel to look where is a real relative advantage. And I maintain that the Technion, it attracts the talented young people to get educated in the areas that are really needed.
And it's really creating technologies that have an impact on the entire world, that save people's lives, that change people's lives. These kind of solutions are going to come from technology, and those technologies are largely going to come from Israel and from a place like the Technion.
In all my years involved in Jewish life, I have never found a better way to invest my time and effort and resources than in the Technion, which offers security for today and the promise for the type of Israel we want tomorrow that will truly be a light to the nations.